Hey folks, how you doing? Welcome to Out Late But Great's channel. And I am Mainly Butch, another YouTube vlogger, and I have been asked to fill in this week for Jim from Ohio, who is on vacation, and I hope he's having a really great time. Of course, I volunteered to fill in for Jim before I knew that the topic was going to be so tough. Gina, another Out Late But Great guest vlogger and fan and fellow vlogger on YouTube, brought the topic to the table today. And the top, and let me read you the question real quick. At what point can we start living our lives as ourselves and not spend our lives educating others to understand we are just as human as they are? Will this happen? Will this ever happen? How different would your life have been if you could have always been who you are now? How nature intended, as Sally Field said in her acceptance of an HRC award. As everybody knows, Sally Field's youngest son is a gay man, and Sally got the award for the work that she does toward LGBT basic life improvement and improvement of understanding across the board. Well, I had to think about this for a really long time, and I'm not sure how well my answer, you know, is really put together here, but let me just kind of put it this way. I don't feel, other than through my YouTube channel, that I spend my life educating or responding to others, you know, and how they feel about me. I feel like I have lived my life fairly authentically and as who I am since I was about 22. I came out around 22 publicly. I was out before that to myself and close friends, but I was in the military and could not be out publicly because at that time they didn't even have Don't Ask, Don't Tell. So yeah, let me age myself a little bit here. They had, you know, if we find out, we're kicking you out. And that was, you know, and I didn't want that kind of discharge from the Army. I enjoyed the service. I enjoyed the military. I liked the challenge. And I did not want that on my record. But listen to what I just said. I didn't want that on my record. I didn't want the fact that I was who I am on my record. You know, I mean, does that even make sense? No, it didn't make sense to me as I just said it. You know, I mean, I didn't want that, the gay word, on my record. You know, so I guess, yeah, maybe I still am defending it. You know, because it was a bad thing back, you know, in the 80s to have a discharge because you were LGBT on your record. Or because they even suspected you were LGBT. Excuse my phone as it chimes off in the background. Somebody must want to talk to me. So anyway, yeah, how different would my life have been if I could have always been who I am? I think, you know, when I was younger, I may not have been such a rebellious kid, you know, always feeling very misunderstood, but not being able to tell anybody why, you know, but then again, I mean, you know, I did a lot of the things that I wanted to do. I mean, I played Cowboys and Indians. I played Army. I played Cops and Robbers, you know, and I always played, you know, the cop or the robber or the cowboy. And I mowed the lawn with my shirt off until I was 10, you know. I did those things when I was young. And then, you know, as my body sort of started to take shape as a female body, I realized that I couldn't do those things anymore. And then I became a very confused teenager, you know, and I resorted to self-harm and, you know, drug abuse, drug and alcohol abuse. And so maybe that wouldn't have been part of my life had I been able to live authentically as who I was, who I am. Through that part of my life, maybe I wouldn't have been so troubled. Maybe I would have been more relaxed. I wouldn't have been such a stressed kid. But it just wasn't to be. And I feel like every step that I've taken, every little piece of things that have happened to me in my life have shaped who I am, you know, have shaped the type of person I am, you know, have shaped me in ways that I wouldn't have been shaped without those experiences and without going through that struggle as a teenager with my sexuality. Would I be so comfortable with it now? I don't know. I'm very comfortable in my lifestyle now. I live a very open life. I don't hide. Yeah, I get crap because I'm butch. I find myself educating on occasion because of that. Will it ever end? I don't know. I think as long as we still have small enclaves of people in the hill countries of around the America, that you're still going to have bred in and taught bias and prejudice against LGBT people, period. I don't think those that'll die out of that crowd for another 50 years. But maybe in 50 years it'll die out and people will realize that, there was more than two gender identities, male and female. That there are more than two, there more than one sexual orientation, that being heterosexual, as being the one that seems to be recognized as the only one that's okay. they just won't, maybe people, and I think people are understanding now that we are normal, just part of life. This is just who we are. This is how we were born. This is as nature intended, and I think that nature may have intended us to each walk these struggle roads to make a better tomorrow for the kids coming ahead of us. That we need to struggle through everything. If you think back in history to where we are today as the American society, we didn't just get here. There was a huge struggle that brought us to the freedom that we enjoy today, a huge struggle that brought us to where we are today. And I think in the LGBT community, that huge struggle is still going on to some degree, but it's not going on anywhere near the way it was, people. Think about it. We have come strides, We have come leaps and bounds. We've got the President of the United States ordering, the legal system of the United States not to recognize DOMA. Hello. We have equality laws that are coming into being. We're going to vote on the Marriage Act here in Maine in a few days. And I really believe it's going to pass with flying colors this time. So many more people are coming out and standing by us because, as America goes, we grow. We grow, and we pull things along, and we push things along. The older crowd is pulling the fight up, and the younger crowd is kind of giving it a little push. And pretty soon that younger crowd will be pulling, and the ones that come after them will be pushing. And we all just take turns, and the struggle goes on. Humanity's always going to have some sort of struggle, And I think that nature intended us to be a struggle. An intended life to be a struggle. And, whether you're LGBT or you're hetero fighting for freedom or whoever you are, it doesn't fucking matter, as Sally Field said also in that speech, which I thought was one of her most powerful lines in the speech, Yeah. So, anyway, that's my take on this. I don't know that I can imagine a life that didn't have some struggles surrounding being a LGBT. I almost said something else, but I struggle with being LGBT personally. I personally struggle with being a lesbian living with HIV. That's a hell of a struggle right there. Try to tell people you're a lesbian with HIV. I mean, Jesus Christ, they like, well, lesbians don't get HIV. Then you got to start doing some educating. And then, the butch thing, that's always an education. That is an education even to within the LGBT community. People just don't get my gender, and even other lesbians don't get my gender. And the femme lesbians, they do get it. The other lesbians don't understand the femme lesbians either. But we're all just human. And we all just walk the walks we walk. We fight the struggles we struggle with. And we're all gonna make it. It's gonna be okay. So anyway, I thank Out Late But Great. I thank you, Gina, Michelle, Jim. Oh gosh, who else? Oh, I can see you in my head. Sydney. I'm probably forgetting some people, but I thank all of you for allowing me to guest vlog this week, and I hope that some of you will come over and subscribe to my channel as well. And if you're not a subscriber here on Out Late But Great, hit that button right there and subscribe. Yeah, this is a great channel. Peace. Have a good one.